Crystal the Snow Fairy, Rainbow Magic by Daisy Meadows. A magical surprise. Isn't it a beautiful day, Mom? Christie asked happily. She gazed out of the car window at the blue sky and sunshine. Do you think it will stay like this for all summer vacation? Mrs. Tate laughed. Well, let's hope so, she said. But remember what the weather on Rainbow Island. It was always changing. Christie smiled to herself. She and her parents had been to Rainbow Island vacation during the last school break. Christie had made a new friend there, Rachel Walker, and the two girls were now shared a very special secret. They were friends of the fairies. When Evil Jack Frost had put a spell on the seven rainbow fairies and banished them from Fairyland, Richard and Christie had helped the fairy sisters get back home. Could Rachel come and stay with us for a little while, Mom, please? Christie asked as they pulled up outside their house. The Tates lived in Weatherbury, a pretty village in the middle of the countryside. A really good idea, Mrs. Tate agreed. Now let's take the stuff inside, okay? Said Christie, climbing out of the car. Where's Dad? Just then, a voice called out from the distance. Hello, I'm up here. Christie glanced up, shading her eyes against the sun. To the left of the house was an old wooden barn. Mr. Tate was standing at the top of a ladder next to the barn, holding a ham. I'm just repairing the barn roof, he explained. It's been leaking. Oh dear, said Mrs. Tate, opening the car trunk. She handed two shopping bags to Christie. We really have to do something about that barn. It's falling down. I like it, Christie replied. Suddenly, she jumped. Something cold and wet had landed on her nose. Oh no, she exclaimed. I think it's raining. Then she stared at the white flake that had landed on her picture. It's not rain, she kept. It's snow! Snow? Mrs. Tate looked shocked. But it's in summer. It can't be. But it was snow. In a flash, the sky had turned gray with snowflakes were floating down. Quick, Christie, let's get inside, called Mrs. Tate, grabbing the rest of the shopping bag, closing the trunk of the car. Mr. Tate was already climbing down from the ladder. They all rushed inside as the snow swirled around them. This is very strange, said Mr. Tate, groaning. I wonder how long it will last. Christie glanced at the kitchen window. Mom, Dad, the snow had already stopped. Mr. and Mrs. Tate joined Christie at the window. The sun was shining and the sky was a few puddles of water were all that remained of the sudden snowstorm. Well, said Mr. Tate, how strange. It was almost like magic. Christie's heart began to pound. Could there be magic in the air? But why? She and Rachel had fed all of the rainbow fairies, and Jack Frost had promised not to harm them again. Everything was fun in Fairyland now, wasn't it? You'd better go and change out of that wet shirt, Christie, said her mom. Christie turned away from the window. As she did, she spotted something on the kitchen table. It was a rusty old medal with the ring in the shape of a rooster. What's that? She asked. I found it in the park this morning, her dad said. It will look great on top of the barn once I'm done fixing the roof. Christie reached a hand toward the weather vane. As she did, the metal glowed and gleaming sparkles danced toward her fingers. Christie blinked in surprise and then she looked again. The sparkles had vanished. All she could see was the rusty metal. Christie ran upstairs to change. Had she managed It's the sparkle. Maybe the snow is real, though. She was sure of that. I'll call Rachel after lunch, she thought. Maybe she's been noticing strange things, too. Kirstie hurried to her bedroom. There on a shelf above her bed was the snow globe the fairies had given her. It was a very special thing, a gift from helping the Rainbow Bridge. Rachel had one, too. It was filled with glitter and fairy dust and all the colors of the rainbow. When the snow globe was shaken, the dust swirled and sparkled inside. Right now, no one was shaking the snow globe, but the fairy dust was swirling around inside the glass. Kirstie forgot about her wet shirt and kept staring at the sparkly snow globe. She couldn't believe her eyes. It must be magic, she whispered. She ran across the room and grabbed the glass globe, but she dropped it with a gasp of pain. The snow globe was so hot it had burned her finger as the globe. It hit the edge of the shelf and scattered. Oh no, Kirstie exclaimed, upset that she'd broken her beautiful gift. Just then, sparkling fairy dust flew from the air and floated down around her. Before she knew, Kirstie was shrinking. It was just like on Rainbow Island. She and Rachel had become fairy size when they helped rescue the rainbow fairies. Now they were teeny all over again. Kirstie twisted around and looked over her shoulder. There were her fairy wings, delicate and glittering. Maybe the fairies want me to fly to Fairyland to see them, Kirstie said to herself, but I don't know how to get there. As she spoke, the fairy dust drifted around her. Suddenly, a strong breeze swept in through the open window. It picked up the fairy dust and whipped it into a whirlwind of glitter. Then the whirlwind lifted Kirstie gently into the air and carried her right out of the window.